首先我还是为今天所有到场的这些球迷朋友们，包括在电机前给我们这个国家队加油助威这些球可爱的球迷朋友们，然后说一声谢谢。然后今天呢，营造了一个非常好的一个主场的一个氛围，然后呢，球员也很兴奋，然后呢，对我来讲，球队也取得了一个胜利，然后呢，球员也相互之间更加的通过这个比赛，也可以更加的熟悉跟默契，然后很好，我们赢下了一场比赛啊，谢谢。
Okay, first of all, I would like to thank the lovely football fans who come to the stadium and support us. They created a very good environment and atmosphere for the stadium, and our players are all very exciting. And I think this victory is grateful for the team. So the players will work better with each other, and we will have a better team.
好，感谢李指导。接下来是媒体提问环节，首先请红区媒体举手提问，在提问前请报出媒体单位。直接说就行。
中央广播电视总台记者想问一下主教练李铁。其实这场比赛呢，应该说关岛队是一种怎么说密集防守，然后除了门将有六名后卫，就可能下一场我们面对的对手还是会有这样的情况。您觉得在破密集防守上，这场比赛球员是否做到了您的部署？然后对接下来的比赛是否有非常重要的这种实战意义？然后另外想问一下吴磊，我们都知道啊，这是时隔疫情期间，由于疫情时隔598天，中国队的再一次的主场比赛。所有球迷又可以看到中国队的比赛，然后你也从欧洲归来参加这场比赛，你能表达一下你当时在球场上比赛一种最真实的感受是什么？谢谢。
Okay, two questions. First one for the head coach today. We have played against a low block team, and the next game with Maldives, for sure that they will also play low block. So your arrangement for this match, do you think it works? And will it also works for the next game? Question for Wu Lei, after 598 days pandemic, due to the pandemic, after 598 days, this is the first time you come back on the field. Can you share with us your feeling?
首先有请李指导回答。
对方整场比赛基本都在后场紧缩防守，然后呢，其实我们上半场也同样创造了很多机会，可是呢，能感觉到球员可能是太长时间没打国家队的这种公开比赛了，还是有一点点的着急，然后呢，所以上半场创造几个机会呢，并没有把握住，然后呢，但是下半场明显就比上半场好了很多，然后这对于我们来讲，其实就是一个一场不错的比赛，让球员好好的来热一下身，然后体会一下，世预赛的这种感觉，然后为后边的这个三场比赛做个准备啊。
Okay, yes, during the whole game, Guam just play low block at their defensive third. And for the first half, we have a lot of chances too, but maybe after too long time, our player didn't play. So I think they need more patience, and they missed some very good chances. And in the second half, we did much better. I think this is a very good match, and a good game for the team, and the player can build their self-confidence and have the feeling for the next three games.
好，下面请吴磊回答。
首先非常感谢球迷们这个到场，给我们加油助威吧，因为确实因为疫情将近2年时间没有在这个有球迷进场的情况下比赛，所以我们球员作为球员来说也非常的兴奋。然后今天球迷给我们营造了很好的主场氛围，我也希望后面的比赛能够给球迷带来更多的这个胜利，给他们带来更多的欢乐。
Okay, I would like to appreciate all the football fans come here to support us. You know, it's quite a long time that we play without spectators. So this game, during this game, I was really excited. They created a perfect atmosphere in the stadium, and in the future, I want to bring them more joy and more victory.
同学体育记者，有两个问题，一个问题问主教练，你怎么点评阿兰的表现？他打进了两个球，未来是否会出现在球队的首发阵容当中？另外一个问题提给吴磊，这是你第一次代表李铁的国家队比赛，感觉这个适应和熟悉程度怎么样？未来是否能就是在比赛当中踢更多的时间？谢谢。
Okay, two questions. First one for the head coach. Can you give us some comments with the performance of Alan today? In the future, will you put him in the starting list? And for Wu Lei, the question is, this is your first game for this new national team. What's your feeling?
这是一个赛会制的一个比赛，然后我不太想去单个去评价某一个球员，每一个球员都可能是变成这个国家的英雄，他现在可能是替补，但是可能下场比赛就是首发，然后呢可能只上场五分钟，但他就变成了国家的英雄，这都是有可能的。所以我们现在必须在我们球队用27个球员，所有球员都要准备好去比赛，我觉得这更重要。然后在这场比赛当中呢，其实我非常满意的是我们所有球员在球场上表现出这种精神的状态啊，其实我们都知道这个对手很弱，但是你可以看到我们所有的球员在场上真的是都竭尽全力，然后每一次的拼抢防守包括进攻大家都做得很好，丢球以后就反抢，然后大家在球场上所表现出这种精神状态和这种斗志是让我特别满意的地方。谢谢。
Okay, you know, this tournament is more like a centralized competition, so everybody may have the chance to become a hero. Maybe this time he was on the bench, but next time he may become the starting player. Even if you only play 5 minutes, you will still have the chance to be the hero of the nation. So I wish all my 27 players, everyone must be ready, because I think that will be more important for the team.And for this game, I'm really happy about the mental part. You see during the match, they did very well during the pressing, doing the organization and everything. I'm very happy.
确实因为这个疫情的原因，大概将近一年半的时间没有这个回国家队吧。但是其实每次集训我都和球队在一起，微信群里球队都会把我拉进去，球队的这个作息时间其实我都能够看到，也能够感受到，能知道球队每天在做些什么。所以从这方面来说，其实我一直也是和球队在一起，包括所有的队友其实大家都非常熟悉的，也不存在什么陌生的地方。然后这次回来给我感觉印象最深刻的是整个感觉球队的整体氛围非常好，大家非常有凝聚力，在主教练的带领下，包括这个平时训练包括比赛的节奏，主教练一直给我们强调，这个是一直给我们强调和灌输的，所以这个是我回来感受比较大的一个地方，也是我们进步的地方。
Okay, yes, due to the pandemic, it's almost 1.5 years I didn't join the national team, but you know, during every camp, I was also involved in the WeChat group. I always together with my teammates, for every day their daily schedule, their discussion in the group, I always follow. So I'm not alone. I'm always with the player, with the teammate. I think in this team, is the atmosphere in the team is really good. And after BTS coaching, I think the tempo of the training and the gaming are improved very well.
中央广播电视总台记者，想问一下李指导，这是你带领中国队上任以来第一场正式的比赛，这种感觉，而且是这么重要的这样一个比赛，这种感觉和你以往带队的有什么不同的地方？你的体验是什么
？Okay, for the head coach, I know this is the first official game since you became the head coach. Can you share us, tell us the difference of the feeling?
其实对于我来讲，第一场比赛是东亚杯的比赛，但是呢今天呢是从正式的角来说可能是我的第一场比赛。我刚刚说了，我真的是非常感谢到场这些球迷，然后这营造了一个最近这个两年多的时间最好的这种氛围的一场比赛，然后我会记住一辈子这场比赛。
Okay, for me, the first game I coached in the national team is the game in the E1 Cup. But yes, as you mentioned, this is the first official game I coached. I still want to thank the football fans who came today to support us. They created the best environment for the past 2 years. I will remember it all my life.
接下来是绿区媒体提问环节，请在提问前报出媒体单位。请问绿区媒体有无问题？
好，李指导，你好，山东台的记者，今天上场比赛
有点听不清。
稍等，请再重新说一遍，声音稍微有点听不清。
李指导，你好，山东台的记者。那么今天上半场比赛呢，金敬道跟吴廷涵也是首发出场了。那么其中呢，金敬道也是收获了一粒进球，请您评价一下他俩的发挥，谢谢。
Okay, for the first half, 金敬道 and 吴廷涵 started as the starting player. Can you give us some comments with these two players?
这个刚刚那个赵宇提问的时候说的是同样的，问的阿兰，这个是金敬道和吴廷涵。我不太想在这种场合去单个评价某一个球员，我觉得所有球员今天的表现都是非常好的，都非常尽力啊，谢谢。
Okay, I think I have the same answer for you as the one I gave to Zhao Yu. You know, he also questioned about the performance of Alan, but today I don't want to give any comments for any individual players. They did all did very well. Thank you.
想问一下您两个问题，第一个问题是我注意到赛后的时候，您是在球员现场的时候，您是一个人走到了中圈的这个附近，我想问一下您当时在想什么。然后第二个问题就是想问一下您，今天您刚刚也提到说，可能今天球队在机会把握能力方面还存在着一定的欠缺，那么接下来的几场比赛，我们如何让这方面得到更好的这个调整和提高？谢谢。
Okay, two questions. I found that after the game, when our player gave very thanks to our fans, you were just walk in the middle of the field. Can you share us what have you thought at that moment? And as you mentioned, we need to improve the finishing. How to improve it?
第一个，我的习惯是这样，每场比赛之后呢，我可能会跟对方的主教练去表示一下感谢，然后会跟裁判表示一下感谢，然后呢，一般的话我会站在球场中间看着我们的球员去跟球迷，然后去谢场，然后我也会跟他们在一起，然后呢，我觉得球迷是最辛苦的，然后我也希望能站在那里给球迷表示我的这种敬意。第二个问题是什么？你先说吧。
Because it's, I always do it. You know, after the game, I just want to be there to say thanks to the head coach of the opponent team and say thanks to the referees. I also want to watch my players. They give thanks to the fans because I think.They all worked very hard. I want to show my respect to them. 第二个问题是
射门那个是吧 ？OK， 那我不能指望是说一共有出来三个机会，吴磊都给踢进啊。
Okay, for the finishing, we cannot say that. So we have three chances. 吴磊
开个玩笑啊。
All the chances to become three goals, but just to
开玩笑。我觉得最重要的是我们在球场上制造出了很多的机会。
But I think we do created a lot of chances.
但这场比赛对方，我还没看技术统计，好像应该正常，应该是没有一个角球，没有一个前场任意球，也没有一个射门。这说明我们在防守端做的是非常好的。我们在持续给对手压力，然后我们也创造了很多很多的射门，的机会。然后呢，我觉得球队已经做得足够好了。
I haven't checked the match data yet, but I believe that during this game, Guan they didn't make any shots or even any corner kicks. I think that means that we organized our defense very well. We give them enough pressure, and I think we did also organized very well during the game.
好，绿区媒体最后一个问题。
我想问一下那个吴磊，我是上海新闻晚报的记者。这场比赛现在中国队在上半场只是为了打破僵局的情况下，你表现非常出色，为中国队应该说打开了胜利之门。那么，但是呢，你是经过一番长途跋涉，然后呢，跟国家队的合练机会很少。我想问一下，这段时间你自己对自己有哪些的调整，特别的调整，或者付出了哪些努力吗？还有就是，可能有些人质疑你在国外踢的只是西乙联赛，然后可能很多时候又是替补，可能会一些质疑吧。那你觉得你在国外的这种球队这种训练比赛，对你是心理上啊，还有个人能力上有没有一些帮助和提高？谢谢。
Okay, question for Wu Lei. You made a very important goal during the first half to open the game. I know that you travel a very long distance from Spain back to China. And after these days, after you join the team, do you have special arrangement for yourself to adjust? And also we know that your team was in the second division of Spain last year, and you didn't play many games as the starting player. But do you think this overseas experiences helped you a lot?
首先回到国家队，其实作为我个人来说，其实心情是非常兴奋，也非常激动的。虽然说这个确实长途旅行，可能这个确实会有一些疲劳，但是其实回到队里之后，来到队里之后，这种大家给我这种帮助，包括回到这个非常亲切的大家庭，我觉得能够缓解我精神上或者心态上的一些疲劳。所以这个其实对于我来说的话，我觉得自己还是能够适应这种节奏的。第二个问题是这个回到国家队之后，其实我觉得这次回来我也看到了我们球队的这个，就像我刚才说的，这个有非常大的进步的地方。这个李导一直给我们强调的就是这个快节奏，包括前场的这种就地的反抢，所以这个我觉得非常好，对我们国家队这个之后的这个比赛来说的话。另外我觉得其实能够来到国家队每一个球员都是中国最好的球员，所以我觉得这个所有的比赛都是我们每一个球员去完成的，通过每一天努力的训练去完成的，不是说靠某一个球员。我觉得我们大家是一个集体。
Okay, for sure that. But first of all, I'm very happy to join join the team. And the long travel is really tired, but. Since I came back to the big family, I got a lot of help from my teammates, from my family members, and that helped me a lot. And as Coach Li Tie just mentioned, this team improved very fast. As a team cannot rely on some individual players. We are teammates, we are team, we have to work together.
这个事儿我想说两句啊，这个这些在外边有时候经常会质疑吴磊啊，或说这些说东说西的人，真的我觉得你们真的可以闭嘴了，不用再说这些东西了。这个因为我在国外待过，你们应该知道，在欧洲，尤其在这一个完全不熟悉的一个国度，在那边打拼，尤其是五大联赛，这是中国现在唯一一个球员，你们非得给他说的，他也不在国外待了，回中国踢你们就高兴了？没有，我们在这儿应该所有人能够看到吴磊的进步，虽然在欧洲有时候可能踢得多点，可能踢得少点，但总体来讲他还是得到了很多的成长。等到将来可能5年10年以后他退役了，他把这些学到的东西带到中国来，这样才会帮助到中国足球。所以这些人真的你们不用再说了，好好看球吧啊。
Okay, I won't give some word to these people who give the careless comments to Wu Lei when he played in Spain. For me, I also had the overseas played experiences. I know how difficult it is.So for us, I think we just let Wu Lei play and let him bring the good experiences and the good things back to China.
好，2022国际足联卡塔尔世界杯暨2023亚足联中国亚洲杯联合预选赛第二阶段关岛队与中国队的比赛，中国国家男子足球队赛后新闻发布会到此结束，稍后将进行关岛国家男子足球队赛后新闻发布会，谢谢。
谢谢。